not ashamed to cry. And I am yours. I am your teacher. hello. Welcome. My name is, well, it is Miss West, or it was Miss West. I got married last Friday. that is why I am not with you guys right now, meeting you. I am so sorry I'm not there. But I did get married last Friday. I am now Mrs. Jackson. And I have to take my husband to the airport today, because he is flying back to England. So I am so sorry I'm not there to say hello to you in person, but I figured a video would suffice for now. I am so excited to see you all on Wednesday and get this year started off right. But I just wanted to give you a little video to tell you a little bit about myself. I am, first of all, super happy that you're in my class. For those of you that had me last year, welcome back. And for those of you that have not had me yet, I cannot wait to meet you. A little bit about me. I got married last Friday. I had a surprise wedding. My husband is from England and he has a son there. And we had an engagement party that turned into a surprise wedding last Friday. So he had to fly back to take care of his son, and I will be joining them in a year's time. So you guys will be my last American students. So we will make it a great year. I cannot wait for this. I am moving to England, yes, in a year. Joshua, my new bonus son, is 7 years old. He is adorable. I have two nephews, by the way, that live here in Pensacola. One is 7 and the other is 5. He'll be 6 this November. I have a really big family here in Pensacola, and obviously all my friends and family I love here so much. I love to read and dance. Obviously, I dance at the beginning of most of my videos. It's very cringy. I apologize, but I do love to dance. So, and yeah, not at the same time. I don't read and dance at the same time. That's dangerous. I'm clumsy, so that's very dangerous. Feel free to laugh at me anytime I fall in class. It will happen. I know it will. I also scuba dive when there's time. It's been a couple years actually since I've gotten to go, but I really do enjoy scuba diving so, so much. Yeah, so this is my bonus son, Joshua, and this is my husband, Mark. He's so cute. Okay, just to let you know a little bit about me. I have been teaching, I think this will be my 10th or 11th year. It's a blur. I have taught all 3 grade levels of math, 6th, 7th, and 8th. So I'm well versed in all of them. I've created a YouTube channel that has videos for all 3 grade levels. So be sure that if you're watching one of my videos, that you look at the playlist for the grade level that you're in. So obviously you're in 6th grade, make sure that you're under the 6th grade playlist. Now, if you want to check out the other playlist, feel free. You're welcome to, of course. But if you're watching something for my class and if I'm having you take notes on a certain lesson, then make sure that you're in that grade level, because I've had students before who copied down the wrong lesson. Anyways, wasn't very helpful for them. I also have my videos on stream in ClassLink, and sometimes I will add them to Teams page, and it'll make it easier for you to access sometimes there. But my YouTube channel is #MathNerdsChannel, and you can check that out. It's easiest if you can go ahead and subscribe to it. No, kids, I do not make any money off of this YouTube channel. It's strictly for you guys to learn during the school year. So, but it will make it easier for it to pop up on your page if you do subscribe to my channel. And yeah. Supplies that you'll need for my class. I have Expo marker tables. No, I have dry erase tables that the students are allowed to write on if they have Expo markers. You cannot write on them with anything other than Expo markers. So if you want your child to have Expo markers, you would need to purchase them. Or the students can purchase one from me for $1. Obviously, it's a better buy if you go ahead and purchase their own markers, but I do sell them for $1 each. They don't have to have one. It's not a requirement. It's just, it makes math a little bit more fun when the kids get to write on the furniture and practice their math problems that way. But absolutely, they can use paper and pencil, and then that's fine too. They will need a spiral notebook and a pocket folder. Spiral notebook is going to be used for notes, and their pocket folder will be used for any worksheets or papers that we hand back. They will need a pencil for worksheets and tests, and erasers, because everybody makes mistakes, myself included. But mistakes are proof that you're trying, so that's always good. And then graph paper. I think it's super helpful to have graph paper on hand. We will be graphing in both 6th and 7th grade this year, but also graph paper helps you keep things in a line. So sometimes we're not the best at staying organized with our thoughts and with our writing and our math, but it's really good to line things up in math. Sometimes we can get the answer completely wrong if we're a little bit sloppy. So graph paper helps us really line up those numbers. So graph paper might be really helpful for those of you that have that difficulty. But even if you don't, we will be using graph paper this year throughout the year. So it would be helpful to have some of that on hand. If you need me, it is best to email me. I don't know if my email is going to be changing now that my last name is different. But as of right now, my email is westle@santarosa.k12.fl.us. And if I do happen to change my email address to something else, I will, of course, let your students know so that they can get the information to you. I am available for tutoring every morning in my class from 7 to 7:30. It might be 7 to 7:25 now. All buses get to school at 7 o'clock, so the kids can go and get their breakfast if they eat breakfast at school, and then they can come to my room if they need extra help, and I'm happy to help them every single day. And that's free from 7 to 7:25 every single day. If they need my help, they're welcome to do that. And don't worry, you got this. I'm so excited to be your teacher this year. I'm really excited to teach you math and to make it as fun as possible. I know math is not always everybody's favorite subject, but it is my, well, it wasn't my favorite subject back in school, but it is my favorite subject now because I really try to think of it in a different way. Oh, my apologies. I think of it in a different way, and I try to make it as fun as possible. So we will have fun doing that this year together, and I cannot wait to meet all of you in person. Feel free, parents, if you need to email me or with any questions, I'm happy to answer them. But I can't wait for this year to get started. I'll see you guys soon. Bye.